Hello, everybody. This is Toni Turner, and welcome to the market now as of about noon Eastern on Friday, June 21st. Well, stocks slipped earlier this morning. Then the Dow and the S&P rallied to new all-time highs as the White House quieted rising tensions between the United States and Iran. Now, as well this week, the Federal Reserve has signaled an interest rate cut, and it could come as early as July. Of course, that meeting takes place July 31st, sparking a rally in stocks this midday that helped the S&P 500 index rise to a new record high and the Dow rise to a new record all-time high. So pretty interesting day today. So let's go on and look at that now with three charts that could kind of give us some insight into the week to come. Now, today we're going to do something a little different with these new all-time highs. I want to look at a daily chart with you of the S&P 500 index itself. Now, today when I captured this chart, I'm going to call it the SPX because that's the index symbol it goes by a lot of the time. So the SPX, and we don't have an index, a symbol to give you here to trade, because you can't trade an index. You can trade a derivative of it, like an exchange-traded fund, or even go into futures, but you can't trade an index. That's why there's no volume on it. But I wanted to look at it today anyway. I think it's interesting, especially with these new all-time highs. Now, when I captured this chart today, the S&P, I'll call it the SPX, was trading at 2956.49. That was near the new all-time intraday high so far today of 2964. Now, that took out the prior all-time closing high of 2945 on the SPX on April the 30th. So that was about right there. So we took that out today. That's kind of cool. On the RSI, though, what we're looking at down here as traders, we always want to look for what we have to worry about. Not only are we at price resistance here, pretty close to price resistance from that prior April high, but as you can see here, the RSI, this is the 14-day RSI, momentum indicator, relative strength index is what it stands for. Right now, it's at 68.97. Now, when it gets into overbought territory, which would be rising over this line, which comes in at 70, then we have to kind of pay attention. Now, again, the RSI is touching the overbought zone, so we're going to have to see here, can the SPY, can the SPX continue to climb the S&P 500 over these highs here, over 2956? Or is it going to take a little rest here? And that could be because we're still in this price resistance zone. If it does slow, and also coming up here to the RSI almost to overbought, if we look left on the chart, we see the last time that the RSI rose into overbought territory, rose into this above the 70 line, we'll call it, into this zone up here. Then within a few days, the SPX did take a pullback here. So we got to keep an eye on that. We know it's in price zone. If the SPX does have to take a rest here, we have nearby support down here at 2910. We also have the 50-day moving average coming in at 2878. That has nice price consolidation on top of it, so that could be nice price support here. We also have 2800 as price support here for the SPX, and of course the 200-day moving average coming in at 2775. So lots of price support here if the SPX does need to pull back, but yes, of course, it would be very nice if it continues this uptrend. We'll have to see with price resistance and the RSI getting so close to this overbought zone. The next chart we're going to look at today is one we do look at every week, or most every week. This is the Invesco QQQ. Now, the Invesco QQQ represents the NASDAQ 100, a very important index in the market. And as I told you before, the top five holdings of the QQQ are the big momentum stocks: Apple, Microsoft, Amazon, Facebook, and Google, or Alphabet. And together, they represent about 43% of the fund's holdings. Now, the QQQ rose as well to an new all-time closing high on April 29th of $191.02. See, that would have been, I believe, this candle right here. But unlike the SPY, if you'll note here, the QQQ has not been able to come back up to its all-time high. Now, the Dow also made a new all-time high today, at least an intraday high. We'll have to see where it closes today. But techs, as strong as they've been, and certainly have been strong in the first of the year, have not been able to rally back up to their prior all-time highs. Now, today when I captured this chart again, the QQQ was trading at $188.88. Now, like the SPY, the RSI here is nearing but not quite at the 70 overbought line on the RSI. Now, we do know from experience that the relative strength index can rise and bump its head like it did back here for quite a long time, while price is continuing higher. It can, as I say, bump its head on the 70 line, but when it does climb above it, then sometimes most of the time we're in for maybe a little drawdown, and as we see that happened here in conjunction with this move up. And this move took a couple of weeks to do, but it gradually, being overbought for this period of time, it gradually started down. The QQQ did fall for a period. So here, if the RSI just bumps its head against this 70 line and doesn't go above it, we don't have so much pressure on us, but we'll have to see what the Qs can do. And of course, nearby support, if the Qs do come in, or does come in, I should say, we have nearby support down here at 185, right along this line here. Of course, we have the 50-day moving average coming in right now, the green line at 183.81. We also have more support here all the way down 184, more support coming in here at about 177 and change, and of course on down to the 200-day moving average at 174. So like the SPY, we do have a lot of price support here should the Qs need to come down and take a rest. Now let's look at a chart we haven't looked at in a while, and they actually made the name a little fancier on it. This is now the iShares U.S. Broker Dealer and Security Exchanges ETF, symbol IAI, and the top holdings, it does have 26 holdings. The top holdings are the CME Group, Goldman Sachs, Morgan Stanley, Market Access Holdings, CBOE. It did reach a low down here of $51.96 on December 26. As you can see, it made a nice V-shaped rally up here, climbing almost but not quite back up to its October highs. It took it a little while to get back up to those levels, so it did the V-shaped rally, then had to consolidate for a while, which is normal for patterns like this. It did pull back in March, pulled back even more in March, and then it started making an uptrend, and you can see where I've drawn the uptrend line here and the channel line up here. It is moving in an uptrend, of course, with the volatility in the market. It's moving back and forth. When I captured this chart today, the IAI is trading at $63.48. It is trading above the 50-day moving average, the green line, which is coming in at 62.60, and the 200-day moving average, which is coming in at $62.37. Now, the 200-day moving average is also below price down here, which is good, at $61.01. So, if the IAI remains strong here, if the market remains strong as well, Come Monday, if it moves up past the 63.48 line, I may add shares to my portfolio. And if it remains strong, I'm going to use $61.80 right below this pivot here as my initial stop. And then, because I'm going to keep a pretty tight stop in this market, then if the IAI continues higher, I will switch my stop to a close below the 50-day moving average. So, and that again is coming in right now at 62.60. So if it does remain strong and keeps higher, I'll switch my initial stop to a close below the 50-day moving average. For right now, though, I want this stop down here right below this pivot. So you may want to keep an eye on the IAI as we go into the coming week. And now, on to the next week's coming economic reports. But first, please join us this coming Monday, June 24th, for our next session of Toni's Market Club. If you're not sure which side of the market to trade or how you can make money in it, let us help. We had some great trades. During our session, we talk about which side of the market to trade. We have a mini trading lesson, and I give you stocks and ETFs that may become ripe for high potential trades. Can't attend the live session? Not a problem. The recording is available to all of our members just a few minutes after the session ends. This is a low-priced, high-value opportunity to learn how to trade more successfully and make more money. So please join us. For more information, go to the link on this screen or click on the button below. And now, on to this coming week's economic reports. Not much economic-wise on Monday. Tuesday, we have the S&P Case-Shiller Index, the Consumer Confidence and New Home Sales Report. Wednesday, we have durable orders, and that, by the way, is any product that lasts over 3 years. We also have our usual crude inventories. On Thursday, we'll have another GDP, or Gross Domestic Product report, our usual jobless claims, also pending home sales, and our usual natural gas inventories. On Friday, we'll have the University of Michigan Consumer Sentiment Report. So, join us again for this coming week's Toni's Market Club. Don't miss out on this terrific opportunity to raise your trading skills and your trading profits. Until next week, keep green on your screen. I'm Toni Turner, and this is The Market Now.